At its core, DMZ is a casual take on the extraction shooter genre, being accessible on console and PC. It has a wide range of in-game tasks, including missions, contracts, looting for forward operating base unlocks, and its own unique take on PvP. This casual nature has led to a healthy player base months past the conclusion of content updates for DMZ. Despite this, there is one task within game that is anything but casual, and that is the unlock for the mastery camo, Serpentine. With how PvP DMZ has become, there are those who would question if this is still possible. But come with me as we begin this monumental journey and answer the question, is Serpentine still possible in 2024? We begin our journey just to the west of Sawa Village, and I make a quick stop at the armory for plates and other equipment. I grab the first vehicle, which happens to be a boat, and I start making my way upriver past Said City. From here, this is where I run into my first obstacle, a player helicopter. So I decide to utilize the scuba gas mask to stay off the radar. After this, I come ashore and I loot around the central part of the map, as it is a low traffic area. And although I want to make my way to the city, as that is my preferred entrance into the Kosher complex, I opt to head to Rohan Oil, as I can see there is airstrikes coming in the city. Once making it to Rohan, I have a quick loot around this little small room, and then I make my way into the Kosher complex. The Rohan Oil entrance or Kosher complex leads you to the external ops. After some quick looting, I soon find one of the AQ laptops and some chlorine that I need towards my barter. From here, I make my way out into the chemical plant, and to free up inventory space, I open up the Alpha Cluster. I work my way back through the center, finding the key to the factory, open that up, and come back and grab the RD4 rad detector. From here, I work my way to the Alpha Cluster, going around the boards to get the unique code to the locked room. Once the room is opened, I secure the diamond drill bit. From here, I make my way back out into the center, into the Defense Research Center. I pick up two more of the AQ laptops that I need, and I make my way to the shop. I make the barter, and the first step for Serpentine Camo is complete with the Ancient Gun Oil. For the next barter, I needed a GPU, and I didn't have any weapon locker keys. So we made a quick stop into Vondel as I had plenty of stage bag keys. I made my way there, grabbed the GPU, made my way to Xville, and headed on out. On Ashika Island, I spawned at the Death Spawn, so I had to move quickly using the water and the coast. I made my way to the waterways entrance, but I could only relax for a short time as I soon become the victim of a hunt contract. I made my way to the hidden underground room where there's only one way in and out and waited it out. From there, I made my way to the underground entrance of the castle, got to the bomb maker, and then I made my way to a buy station where I felt comfortable. I made the barter for the bomb maker's blend and bought a personal Xville. However, I was being trolled as the Xville was put between two others. So I waited it out to the gas, used my personal, and the next step was done with the bomb maker's blend. Now in Vondel, I go for the premium liquor. Now I loot around looking for some vintage wine. In the first game I took down the bullfrog, but I was unable to find his blowtorch. So in the end, I abstracted. Coming in for another game, I was looting around and I decided to take on the bullfrog again for a second time, but I got taken down by another team. Fortunately, they picked me up and recognized what I was doing. We had a pretty epic fight with a couple of teams on the top of Zoo. We even got hunted. We went all the way to Final Xville. It was pretty exciting, and I must show thanks to Hotfoot and Nev, who picked me up and didn't take any of my gear. Game 3 in Vondel, I came in and did some looting around. I did manage to find vintage wine, and then I wore down the timer looting, and then I head to Xville. While looting in game 4, I came across a solo, and I gunned him down while he was distracted by a box, because safety first. I did some more looting, then I headed to the Xville. In game 5, I was flying around the map looking for vintage wine. I ended up being on the wrong end of a hunt contract. And they did manage to get close, but I evaded them. I made my way to a jet ski and got to the other side of the map and survived the hunt. But the relief was short-lived, as I was hunted again. I was close to an Xville, so I thought it's time to dip. Unfortunately, in my panic of the second hunt, I didn't equip my secure backpack, and my first attempt had come to an end. So So before we carry on, I just want to super quick thank Nolsey, who jumped in on a community post that I put up on my YouTube page. Now, unfortunately, when we were having a bit of backwards and forwards, I was working a night shift. Me here in New Zealand, Nolsey on the East Coast, made the time thing a little bit different, but if you're listening to this, mate, I do appreciate the offer. Now, back to the video. So second time around goes off without a hitch, and I make it to the underground car park and into the Cochet complex. I quickly work my way through the information extract and out into the chemical plant. I grab the key and open up the factory wing. I have to stop quickly into the external ops to get the battery and the jumper cable so I can open up the alpha cluster. Once in the alpha cluster, I make my way to the door, I get the code and work my way around the blackboards. From there, I open up the locked room and I get the diamond drill bit. Afterwards, I quickly loot around where I've already been and then back to the buy station, and for the second time acquire the ancient gun oil and then work my way to Xville. As before, I make a quick stop to Vondel and the stage bag key to get the GPU. This goes off without a snag. On a Sheikah, I grab a jet ski and I move quickly away from spawn. I go to a little island where I did my regain video and I gather my thoughts. From there, I swim into the underground waterways and the underground entrance to the castle. I quickly work my way to the bomb maker and eliminate him and grab a screwdriver. I go to a close by station, make the barter for the bomb maker's blend, but I don't buy my personal here as it's central in the map. I work my way back through the waterways and to the buy station at the port. From here, I buy my personal, I wait for the gas, and I exfil without any drama. So back to Vondel, and this time I took out the bullfrog with a precision airstrike, but I didn't loot for the blowtorch straight away. I was looting around in the stadium and another team picked up the weapons case. Once they'd moved on, I'd grabbed the blowtorch and I moved over to do some more looting for the vintage wine, but I soon became the victim of a hunt squad. As I was next to an exfil, I thought I'd quickly get out of there. I burnt my advanced UAV and got out of there just in the nick of time. They tried to parachute onto me as I was on the chop. Nice try, boys. In game 2 on Vondel, I was looting around at the kiosk just next to the zoo. I was stalking for the vintage wine, but all I got was reinforcement of why I disliked the Coney bots. In the end, the only thing I collected was more grey hairs, so I just made my way to Xville. Game 3 back in Vondel, and have a guess what happened. That's right, another hunt. I was pretty close to an Xville, so I made my way there, but to be fair, they rolled up on me pretty quick in a car and the panic set in. They gunned me down, but they were good enough to pick me back up. And there was some negotiation, I was able to get my gear back once I explained what I was doing. They'd already killed the scavenger, so I grabbed the scavenger backpack and we exited. So I had a faulty moment and I didn't record game 4, so what you're watching here is game 5. I'd already found a vintage liquor and then I managed to find the second, so now all I needed was the scavenger calling cards. So I decided to just rotate around the outside of the map past player spawns. So moving around the outside of the map, I found a dead player, so I moved far enough away that the scavenger could spawn. While checking out the map, I seen the scavenger had spawned over at the central station, so I made a beeline straight over there. I grabbed the two calling cards, made my way to the buy station, made the barter for the premium liquor, and by this stage I was excited to be moving on from Vondel. So back in sunny Al-Mazran, I'd bought a skeleton key, I had a good central spawn, so I made my way up Desire, parachuted down to the sniper team's nest, and I grabbed the stealth and the comms from the locked room. From here I grabbed a helicopter and I made my way to the radiation zone to see if I could take out the chemist. I dropped an airstrike on some bots, but in the end I got overwhelmed, they burned through my gas mask and 2 self-revives, so I got out of there. In my looting, I found what I needed to craft a medic vest, so from there I just made my way to the Koshi complex. So like earlier runs into Cochet, I infilled through the information extract and I quickly made my way to the list, and like all the others, I had to make my way out to the chemical plant, go to the external ops to open up the alpha cluster. I searched, but in the end I couldn't find a tattered notebook. I found plenty of lab notes, so I had to extract. This one hurt my soul because I had to leave a 2U skeleton key behind. So I spawn in by the 2 construction towers and I make a quick trip over the river and into the Koshi complex. From there, I make my way to the list and I see that this time I don't have to go to the Alpha cluster. I get lucky and I find the 2 items that I need within the information extract, so I quickly make my way to the buy station, I barter for the black cell hand cream, I grab an LT restricted zone card and I extract and leading me onto the home stretch. So for the final time, I spawn into El Mazra next to the construction site. I start making my way across the map towards the radiation zone, which is at the quarry. I stop in at a petrol station and grab a spare scuba gas mask so I can utilize the river to make my way through the map and avoid players. I come ashore in the central part of the map, which is low traffic, and I decide to check out the caves to see if the heavy chopper fuel's there. I clear out the tier 3 AI with my trusty intervention from a distance, and then I move into the cave and find the heavy chopper fuel. From there, I make my way back to the surface. I utilize the radio towers to get across the teak cave and avoid all the AI. I scope out the quarry from height and then I parachute across. At this point, I ignore the scavenger and I go straight for the chemist, taking him out with my intervention. I quickly run in, grab the chemist acid and his advanced UAV, and then I start retracing my steps back the way I came. Using the radio tower again, I get across to Zaya and I come in through the bottom entrance. From here, I make my way to the buy station and then I just wait for the gas. Once the gas comes in, I make the barter. Now, I'd fully intended to go to Kosh to get out, but I can see by a hunt contract that I marked that I was the last one on the server. So I make a mad push for the final X-Fill at El Bagra. So after a week-long grind towards the 17 camo, we go back and ask you the original question, which is this possible in 2024? Well, yes it is, with some caveats. You are reliant on some RNG, whether it being other players picking you up or finding that rare loot like the vintage one on Vondel. That really was a pain in the butt. And like most other content creators have commented, the camo itself is pretty mid. But you don't do it for the camo, you do it for the experience. There's nothing else in DMZ that can offer the adrenaline, the nerves, the high stake risk that is Serpentine. And I've enjoyed myself over the last week completing this task, which some consider to be the hardest within this game mode. Now, if you like this one and you found it entertaining, I'm going to go ahead and ask if you can hit that subscribe button and maybe even leaving me some comments, some feedback. Hit the like button. And as always, guys, until next time, I'll catch you all out there in the DMZ.